No more being nice to everybody. No more saying yes to everyone. No more people pleasing. That is what this video is all about. How can you stop people pleasing without feeling guilty? What is the cure to the disease of people pleasing? That is what this is all about. If you want to break free, if you want to own your life, if you want to make changes in your life, then you have to own your life and choose for yourself. And yes, you can be a very kind and caring person, but here's the thing. What's the difference between being kind and a nice person and compassionate and caring for someone or being a people pleaser? I will explain all of this really easily in this video. And if you don't know me by now, then I am a recovered people pleaser. I know what I'm talking about, and it got me stuck. It kept me stuck all of these years. But then I broke free and I broke through and I escaped my corporate, and I am the happiest person there is. And I'm still helping people. I'm still very caring about people, but I'm also living my own life. And that's the life that I want for you. And that's how I help my clients to break through corporate, to escape, to make a plan, to choose for yourself and that freedom lifestyle without feeling guilty, without regrets. If you haven't done so yet, make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel and click that red button right below and hit that notification bell so you don't miss any of my new videos, because every week I publish videos to help you take steps, to help you take steps to break free and to transform your life. And like I said, I am a recovered people pleaser. And the thing that happened to me is that all of these years, when you're a people pleaser and you say yes to everything and everyone, what happens at the end and after a while of doing that is a lot of stress. You feel tired, you feel exhausted, because you know, I had to be everywhere with everyone, a party here, a coffee there, a talk there. Can you help me here? Can you help me there? Yes, 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 yes. And it's like, you know, I was exhausted. I was stressed. I sometimes woke up in the middle of the night thinking, oh my gosh, you know, it's too much. But then choosing for myself was the hardest thing, because I thought, I don't want to let anybody down. I don't want to say no. But here's the thing, saying no to someone is saying yes to yourself. But I didn't understand all of that. What's important is the difference between being caring and kind and being a people pleaser. And the difference between being a kind person and a people pleaser is the need to be liked. I'm going to repeat that. The difference between being a caring and nice and kind person and a people pleaser is the need to be liked. And we are human beings and we love to be liked. And the more people that like us, the better we feel. But that's the thing. Our self-worth, our self-image is not linked to the number of likes. Compare it with social media. How many people just look at their likes, and if there's no likes and no engagements and no comment, they feel awful. Because like, oh my God, nobody likes me. And I'm not worth anything and I'm not good enough and I'm a nobody. No, your self-worth, your inside, your happiness should not be based on the number of likes. Your self-worth and your value comes from your inside, comes from inside, not from the outside. Because guess what? If you're scrolling down social media and you see all these beautiful pictures and beautiful relations and beautiful successes, people show their best, but they hide their mess. We all have bad days, but we show our best. And that's what you base your worth on? It's the outside image. No, no, no. From now on, I want you to understand that beauty begins the moment you tell your own story. Beauty begins the moment you realize you are unique. Beauty begins the moment you take a mirror, look at yourself. It's called self-awareness. Stop looking at the outside and look at yourself and take care of yourself. And yes, it's okay to take care of somebody. And yes, it's fine to be kind and compassionate. But your life comes first. Your happiness comes first. When you are happy and you feel good inside, that's when you can be happy and help others and help others' happiness. But everything comes from the inside, not from pleasing a whole bunch of people. You cannot like and be friends with the whole wild world. It's not possible. Why would you want that? To feel better? I also need to add that when you please people, you're actually making so much effort to do good to somebody else that you're not fully being yourself. In fact, you can often feel disconnected and lonely even if you're pleasing so many people. Why? Because you're not connected with yourself. And this is misleading. Do you understand how pleasing others and pleasing people is misleading? You are always going outside of yourself and doing good for others, and you're not connecting with yourself because you're afraid that people are not going to like you if you don't show up as your best all the time. It's not possible. We all have good days, we all have bad days, but you are a unique human being. And when you are disconnected with yourself because you're forcing yourself to do good for others and to be the person they want you to be, that's what happened to me. That's why I was burned out. I was always doing my best because I was thinking, I'm expected to do this corporate job, I'm expected to do this, I'm expected to do good for you, I'm expected to say yes all the time. No! I was not being myself. I was not connected with myself. I felt anxious. I felt stressed because I could not be myself. I was forcing myself. So the bottom line is, you are good enough as you are. You are worthy as you are. It's okay to say no, and start by saying no to somebody close to you, somebody you trust, somebody you know it's not gonna, you know, it's okay, it's safe. But start doing it more and more, because saying no to somebody else is saying yes to yourself and realizing that you are worthy, that you can tell your own story. That's where beauty begins. Take a look at the mirror, take a look at yourself and like, I'm good enough, I'm worthy, I can do this. I don't need to be friends with the whole wide world. I don't need to base my self-worth on the number of likes on a page or a Facebook post. You are worthy. Start telling your own story. Connect with yourself. Trust yourself. Do good to yourself. And I have this free training video that I'll put right down below. It's free. 7 steps to get unstuck. And if you have more questions to get unstuck and break through in a good way, in a way that you can trust yourself, that you don't feel guilty, make sure to check the description below and also the comment below. I'll put it right there. Make sure to subscribe to my channel. See you next week for the next video. You are worthy. You can do this. And I'm here to help you. So any questions, pop it down below. I'm here for you.